Members, good morning. It's already the appointed time and we've formed a quorum. May I call the meeting to order? There is only one item for discussion today. The administration has submitted ECI 2023-2046 an information paper for members setting out the changes in the directorate establishment since 2002 and also the implications of the discussion item on the directorate establishment. May I remind members that if you have a direct or indirect pecuniary interest in any of the item today, please declare interest in accordance with ROP 83A. Please disclose the nature of the interest involved before you speak, and please note ROP 84 governing voting procedures on item where you have a pecuniary interest. So, paper EC 2023-2414, the Registration and Electoral Office proposes to create two supernumerary posts in the department, and that is one PEO D1 and one Chief Systems Management D1 in the Registration and Electoral Office for 5 years with immediate effect upon approval of the Finance Committee to take forward the plan to enhance service delivery by improving the electoral arrangements, strengthening planning capabilities and supervision of departmental operation workflow, and advancing the application of information technology. On the 25th, the administration consulted the CA panel, the 15th of May, and taking into account views of the members, the administration has decided to create two supernumerary posts instead. Present for this discussion, we have Mr. Eric Zhang, Secretary for Constitutional and Mainland Affairs, Ms. Gracie Fu, Permanent Secretary for Constitutional and Mainland Affairs, Mr. Freddie Chick, PAS for Constitutional and Mainland Affairs, as well as Mr. Raymond Wong, Chief Electoral Officer from the Registration and Electoral Office. Mr. Holden Chow, Chairman of the CA panel, is present. Can you please report to us the discussion of the item in your panel? Thank you. On the 15th of May 2023, the CA panel discussed this item. Some members queried whether it is necessary to create two permanent posts to continuously improve electoral arrangements and to enhance the application of information technology to enhance users' experience. They are of the view that with the system to ensure the patriots administer Hong Kong in place, the electoral system is not expected to undergo major reforms. And the RUO will continue to use INT to take forward various measures to improve electoral arrangements. And therefore, the directorate establishment of the department should remain unchanged. Some members are of the view that it is better to have two time-limited directorate posts to take forward the relevant work. The administration said that it would continue members' views and has pointed out that while the system has been improved, the office will continue to work with the government to carry out the requirements of the EAC and will continue to improve and review the electoral arrangements and to greatly enhance the use of IT so as to improve efficiency and users' experience to dovetail what is required in future. Members have asked about measures that have been put in place and that the coming DC elections can be used as an opportunity to show the public what has been implemented to improve the situation. The panel agreed that the paper can be submitted to ESC. Thank you. Seven members, including myself, have indicated the wish to ask questions. Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, Ms. Carmen Kan, Mr. Chen Yong, Mr. Holden Chow, Mr. Lai Tong Kwok, Dr. So Chiang Wing, myself, and Mr. Tong Li Zi, 5 minutes each. Dr. Lo Wai Kwok. Thank you, Madam Chair. I speak to support the administration's proposal to create supernumerary posts for the Registration and Electoral Office. I'm pleased to see that the administration has heeded our advice, because previously we have expressed the view that, of course, they have to continuously improve the electoral work, but then it is not really, it doesn't have to be done continuously, and the work may not be regular. So the administration has changed the arrangement to supernumerary posts. We welcome that. After various efforts, the electoral and also a district election arrangements have been improved. I think we all look forward to the district council elections to be held very soon so that we can further improve the situation. I agree that the work involved in these two supernumerary posts is heavy. This is particularly so with the amendments to our electoral legislation. This is the first time we have district elections with a three-tier structure. And of course, the community has high hopes for the administration. Now, for the use of information technology to enhance efficiency. Now, in terms of vote counting, members of the public and electoral team have criticized the efficiency of vote counting. They had to wait for a long time before the results can be announced, even after vote counting has completed, they still have to wait for a long time before the results can be formally announced. I think we really need to step up efficiency. And if this can be done properly, we can make it less tiresome for the staff as well as the candidates and their electioneering team. I'm very grateful to the staff. And if we can be more efficient, then it would be easier for everyone. Secretary, any response? Thank you, Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, for your views and support. Indeed, after we have improved our electoral systems, we are very ambitious so that we can improve and do better in terms of electoral arrangements. We have gone through decades of development in our electoral arrangements. I myself see a lot of room for further improvement, in particular, in terms of the voters' experience and also the electioneering teams. And also the candidates, and even the staff. I hope we can improve on all fronts. Vote counting is a very protracted process. In the recent rounds of elections, we have tried very hard to improve. As said by Dr. Low, if vote counting is protracted, if everyone is already so tired after electioneering, and if they have to wait for so long before results are available, this is not very pleasant. So this is one of the major areas we would like to improve. Vote counting, the voting process, and nomination arrangements. We would like to streamline all these processes to make improvement. We want to create two posts to achieve these effects. Ms. Kamin Kan. Thank you, Madam Chair. First, I'd like to commend the administration for accepting the advice of the CA panel, because when we discussed this item in the panel, members, including myself, have urged the administration to reconsider the arrangement. Now, they've only got one D2 and another D2 leaders in the office. So the work is really heavy. There are ordinary elections as well as by-elections. Their workload is heavy. We advise the administration to start with two supernumerary posts, and they have accepted our suggestion. They are proposing two supernumerary posts for 5 years. I welcome that move. The administration has also set up a subcommittee to consider improved electoral arrangements. So will this new D1 post discuss with the subcommittee on the practical arrangements for improving our electoral system? Very soon, we're going to have district council elections. I'd like to know whether these two posts can introduce new measures in time for the election. IT security is just as important. I have very high hopes for the chief systems manager to be created. In particular, in 2015, there was the leak of voters' information, and we have set up a subcommittee with recommendations to improve IT security. I would like to know whether the chief systems manager to be created will implement all those recommendations to improve IT security. Secretary, thank you. Now, the task force will start this work very soon, and we will take on board views from members on how to improve electoral arrangements. With the creation of the two posts, of course, we will continue to listen to members' views. And then, in our review and in improving our arrangements, we will, of course, adopt those views. As for the coming DC elections, time is tight. If we have the legislative support of members, we are going to carry out the elections in the end of this year. The time is rather tight. Of course, we will work hard to improve the arrangements, but whether we can complete our review so that we can make it the way we like it, then we dare not undertake here, but we'll try our best. The two new posts will see what can be done as soon as possible. And as for the full review, well, we will see to it later. But we will do as much as we can in the coming DC elections. IT security. Thank you, Ms. Kamin Khan, for your question. Well, OGO and also the RUO have set up a sub-task force. There are 31 recommendations and 12 have been implemented already. 8 is in progress. For the remaining 11, we will continue to study them. If the chief systems manager post is created, he will devote his energy to the measures, and he will continue to take forward the remaining work. What about I'm Smart under Para 10G? Now, you say that you're going to disseminate voting-related information to voters through I'm Smart. Can we use I'm Smart for voter registration and change of voters' details in the future? Thank you. That will be our direction. For voter registration, we have completed a pilot scheme. The Immigration Department, Registry of Persons, and also in government buildings, we have pilot points to help voter registration using mSmart. We have dealt with 436 applications. In the light of experience gathered, we are going to improve the system. Hopefully, in next year's voter registration, we will roll that out in full. As regards to suggestions by Ms. Khan, we'll continue to improve our voter registration and use iSmart as far as possible. Thank you.
Mr. Chan Yong, please. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Secretary and Permanent Secretary. In relation to declaration of interest, as we are all returned by election and different political parties have participated in elections, so we are all participants in elections. So I do support the proposed creation of the posts because after the electoral system has been improved, there are many other areas that we have to look at to review and enhance. And while these elections are held, we should continuously improve the process. And I think with the leadership of the Secretary, we do see an improvement in electoral systems. So I do appreciate that. The direction is, of course, enhancing the speed, efficiency, and quality, especially with the speed and effectiveness. We've heard citizens say, because they would often go to banks and jockey club outlets, much of the processes are digitalized, and I think the election process should be the same. I would especially wish to highlight one point. We do see one part of the process that is being improved in terms of voter registration, that you only have to register one time and the process should be done electronically with registration and identification. Before, they had to get a registered post and they have to sign a letter back. Now they no longer have to do that, so we do see an improvement. And I hope that there is much more improvement in the coming DC election so that members of the public will be aware of such improvement, so that members of the public can appreciate the enhancement of the processes. Secretary, please. Well, thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Chan Yong, for your comments. Well, with the coming elections, we do want to see an enhancement in the efficiency and effectiveness. As Mr. Chan Yong said, if we can implement certain measures first, we'll definitely do that. With measures that would require legislative amendments or they would take longer to implement, we'll do it step by step. For things that can be resolved in a short time, we can definitely do that first. For those that we can see, we will definitely enhance those areas as soon as possible. So that is what we've been working on. In future, as Mr. Chan Yong said, in relation to voter registration, we'll take it step by step and improve in those areas. After creation of the two supernumerary posts, the relevant colleague will look into the process to see if there is any further room for improvement. I believe the Subcommittee on Improving the Practical Arrangements for Election Members have been talking to the Bureau on that, and I hope there is better coordination So that we'll get more information in terms of streamlining the processes of elections in relation to electronic voting. Yes, that is definitely the direction we're planning to take. Thank you. We'll definitely work on that in future. Next, Mr. Holden Chow. Thank you, Chair. I do appreciate the Bureau taking note of members' suggestions in relation to creating the two supernumerary posts instead of permanent posts. So that we can monitor the progress. Now, again, I do support this, and I heard the Bureau said in paragraph 10 in relation to voter eligibility review mechanism. Now, I've seen many problems with the inquiry and review mechanisms before, because if they do not respond to letters, they will be disqualified. And there has been much dispute in relation to that before. If we are planning to digitalize the whole process, I want to ask if the government is planning to review the mechanism through the creation of the posts, and that we won't use the traditional way of sending letters, or are you planning to verify voters' eligibility through an electronic process? Now, many members of the public, as they plan to integrate into the national development, they have been living in the Bay Area. So I hope that the government, through the creation of these posts, can take note of the needs of such voters, because they are not ordinarily resident in Hong Kong. But since we are planning to integrate into the development of the country, many of members of the public are living in the Bay Area or other mainland cities. So I think we have to think about how to facilitate the needs of those people. And I hope the two colleagues in these positions can think about that. Well, Secretary, please. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Holden Chow. In relation to the verification of voter eligibility, that is definitely something we're looking into in our review for various areas of a voter registration. That is definitely something that we're reviewing. So please do not worry. We will definitely look into the process to see if there's any room for further improvement. Now, in relation to residents in Bay Area and mainland cities, I believe we'll look into that during meetings of the Subcommittee on Improving the Practical Arrangements for Elections. However, in the legislation and the judgments, there have been clear definitions for people ordinarily resident for electors. So that may be beyond the scope of the review, because this is something defined by law. But we'll definitely look into how to improve the practical arrangements for elections, say for Hong Kong residents living or working on the mainland. We'll definitely see how to facilitate their voting. Thank you. Next, Mr. Lai Tong Kwok. First of all, I would like to express my support for the proposal, and I appreciate the change from permanent to supernumerary posts. I can see in paragraph 10 that they are planning to introduce more technologies to improve electoral procedures. I believe this is to achieve fairness, openness, and effectiveness. Now, in paragraph 10, it is said very clearly how to better use technologies. However, it does not say, the paper does not say the priorities. And in paragraph 11, it was said that for voters, biometric technologies will be used to verify voters' identities so as to enhance voters' experience in the voting process. I think there are more benefits to it because it prevents people from posing as other voters. In paragraphs 10 and 21 in item F, such issue has been highlighted. It was said in the paper that there are five factors to consider. However, the priorities are not set out. So when you said biometric technologies will be used to verify voters' identities, does the government have any schedule for that? Do you expect to implement this technology in the next LegCo general election? The reason why I'm asking that is because I believe it takes time to introduce such technologies. Now, it is 2 odd years away, the LegCo general elections. So I believe that there is ample time for the Bureau to explore the possibility of introduce such technologies in the LegCo general elections. So can you provide a concrete answer to my question on this? Well, Secretary, please. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Lai Chong Kwok, for your questions. Now, our preliminary thought is that with LegCo support for the proposal, we will immediately start our comprehensive review. Well, there are two prongs to that approach. We'll first look into streamlining the process. We'll also look into where we can introduce technologies to facilitate the voting and various electoral procedures. Now, biometric technologies are quite advanced at the moment, and of course it can help prevent, as Mr. Lai Chong Kwok said, people posing as other voters, and it will also enhance the accuracy and reliability. So that is something we're looking into. Now, we're in relation to the priorities. When we're conducting the review, we take it step by step, and then we'll set out the priorities. So that will be dealt with in the review. As for which technologies to introduce in which areas, that would depend on what we are observing during the review, and we will take that into consideration in one go during the review. Thank you.
Next, Dr. So Chang Wing. Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, Secretary. After after we've improved the electoral system, we have held several successful elections, and yet the administration still wants to create posts to further make improvements. I fully support this. As said by the Secretary, we'll have the DC elections very soon. And the two posts will try their best to support the DC elections as far as possible. I know that the two positions are time limited for 5 years, so that you can systematically improve and enhance the electoral arrangements. One of objective of creating the two posts is to further use IT to enhance the openness, fairness, and honesty of elections. I fully support this. You are going to use modern time technology to improve your measures. I'd like to know whether the two officers will start a study on full electronic voting, and whether it's feasible to use biometric features for authentication of voters. If so, can you accord priority to these tasks so that you can make it more efficient and people-oriented and more secure voting arrangements to voters? Secretary, thank you, Mr. Dr. So, for your suggestions. On improving electoral arrangements, using innovation and technology is something we very much want to do, and is in line with the global trend. And as a smart city, we should use technology to further enhance our efficiency and accuracy. These are our objectives. Currently, for some steps and processes, we're already using the IT, such as vote counting and also the distribution of ballots. Whether we can use electronic voting in the future, this will be among the areas we're going to study. If the whole process can be done electronically, I'm sure that will go a long way to enhance efficiency. But we must bear in mind the actual circumstances, including public acceptability, and also whether the systems are very reliable, whether the technology is really mature enough. We'll be very pragmatic in our whole review process. We will look at the possibility of full digitalization, and we will consider that. Let me add, so long as it doesn't violate your legal principles, since the two posts are going to enhance the use of IT and to improve the efficiency of elections. We have over 4 million voters. All sectors of the community would like to have a higher voter participation, and I believe that will be the case. If we can go fully paperless, I'm sure that will improve your operation of elections. Well, the first consideration is our elections must be open and fair. and clean. With that in mind, we will continue to improve our efficiency with the use of technology. This is certainly the way to go. Now it's my turn. Secretary, I'm grateful to the administration for accepting our proposal to turn the two posts supernumerary, and if need be, you can extend it in future. Now you are going to conduct a review. You are going to use a lot of INT, and Paratan has set out tasks that you are going to do. They're going to take time, but some can be implemented sooner, such as our voting time. It used to be from 7:30 p.m. to 10:30, 10 hours, the longest in the world. And then in 2021, it was changed to 8:30 a.m. to 10:30. It is still rather long. Is it really necessary? The establishment camp, in fact, all patriotic members have suggested that the voting time should be from 8:30 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. 12 hours should be sufficient. The arrangement in Taiwan is just the same, and we hope that you can put in place this new voting time as soon as possible. Can that be done? Yes, we have been receiving views from different sectors on the voting time. In the last election, as said by the chair, we have shortened the voting time. For future elections, whether we can further shorten the voting time, we will consider that. And we will also gauge the views from different sectors. The main consideration is still the is to give due consideration to the wish of voters and electors and also members. I don't think you need to convene another meeting on that, because we have discussed that umpteen times in our CA panel. And I also support Ms. Carmen Kan's suggestion that we use I'm Smart for voter registration, because we set up booths in the streets, and is really very complicated. If you can use I'm Smart with good protection of privacy, that will be the best. We also have to tackle the problem of voting outside Hong Kong. Why do we require residents of the Greater Bay Area to vote at our border control points? If we allow people to vote outside Hong Kong, then you can use electronic voting, and you have to address the definition of ordinary resident in Hong Kong. More and more Hong Kong people will live in the GBA area, and that is our target, because the Greater Bay Area is our hinterland. And I hope you can give priority to this, allowing people to vote outside Hong Kong. We have mentioned this to you a number of times. What is your view on that? How can we address the requirement of being ordinary resident in Hong Kong in order to vote? Now, for voting outside Hong Kong, we adopt a very pragmatic approach as well, because a number of issues are involved, covering legislative requirements, operational details, and our collaboration with the mainland. We have to proceed cautiously. When we review our arrangements, we will consider the feasibility of allowing people to vote outside Hong Kong and all the supporting features required to make it possible. We will conduct a full review of these matters before we can ensure that everything is in place to support that. We will still see how we can make it convenient for residents in the mainland to come back to vote. Whether that your suggestion can really be implemented, we have to carry out a comprehensive and meticulous review first. I ask for your understanding. All right, another issue is you don't have to wait until your review is done. I know that you have a very busy schedule. We have vacancies in the Legislative Council by elections. Now, your priority task is to implement the DC elections. What about by elections for vacant electoral seats? We have to discuss with the Electoral Affairs Commission and also the Registration and Electoral Office. With support from the Council, if our reform of the DC arrangements have the support of the Council, and upon passage of the bill, we have to start prepare for the DC elections. It's a full election, and there are new arrangements, there are new constituencies, and so the REO will have to devote its full effort and energy to carry out DC elections. So for by elections of the LegCo, we will find the right time to do it. Thank you. Mr. Tong Lijie.
Thank you, Chair. Improving electoral arrangements, enhanced planning and monitoring of the operational workflow to enhance efficiency, and also the enhanced use of IT to improve our electoral arrangements. Of course, I will support your proposal to boost manpower. But since the reunification, we have seen a number of elections. I think the following point has attracted criticism from all parties, from voters and from the candidates. Now, that recently we had the EC elections, the electorate was not that great, but then voting took too long, and then there was also various sabotage attempts. I don't want the administration to give people the impression that whenever we have problems, you create new posts without showing us the effect of your new manpower. In Paragraph 10, you have set out 10 major areas. We are concerned about the priorities of these tasks. Of course, you may not be able to tell us your priorities now, but I think it's reasonable for us to expect this. We shouldn't have to wait for 5 years before we can see results. Some of the tasks should be completed in 2 or 3 years' time. Otherwise, we will not see any efficiency or effectiveness of creating new posts. In Paragraph 21, you mentioned that you're going to consolidate and simplify the declaration arrangements to reduce manpower. Well, you're not able to give us a full account now. You have to report to us at a certain stage. Can you really streamline your establishment? There are over 150 staff members in your office. Can you really trim your establishment so that manpower can be devoted to things of concern to the community? Can you tell us how you can ensure more voter registration? We want to see changes in the voter turnout. I hope you can do more to encourage more eligible voters to come out to vote, because candidates returned will have a major impact on further development of Hong Kong. So can you comment on this, please, Secretary? Thank you.
Well, I do take note of Mr. Tony Jay's views. Now, in relation to results, of course, we have to deliver them. As Mr. Tony Tse observed, in the recent elections, without the two new posts, we have already been trying to improve the electoral arrangements. We did see room for improvement in certain elections, and after that, in the chief executive election and by election, we have tried to improve the procedures and arrangements, and I hope members can feel that too. That in relation to the voting and counting process, it took much less time. And people did not have to queue really for them to vote in booths. So that is already an improvement. Of course, it has not reached the level that we want to be at in terms of a comprehensive review. With the creation of the two posts, we believe we'll be able to deliver even more results in terms of voter, candidate, and staff members' experience. I believe there's going to be an enhancement, definitely, and that's what we want to achieve. In relation to encouraging eligible voters to vote, we have been explaining to members of the public that with the improved district governance and streamlined electoral procedures, we hope to serve the public better and do better in terms of district work. We hope members of the public will understand that. If members of the public can participate in the process, vote for members that they wish to vote for, that will benefit them as well. So we're trying to make members of the public understand that and in turn encourage them to participate in the voting process. Thank you. Next, Mr. Yu Park Leung. Well, with the improved electoral system, we now have to turn to the practical arrangements, and I believe members of the public have expectations of that. Now, looking at the organization chart, I think the proposal is reasonable, so I will support it. Now, for supernumerary posts, I believe because they'll last for 5 years, they'll get a view of all elections in Hong Kong. And I believe in that way, they can conduct a comprehensive review of all elections. Now, I've also high expectations for the REO in the sense that the procedures for the future elections can be streamlined, and the elections will be conducted in a fair, open, and honest manner, and that it would facilitate voters. Now, as members have said, with the voting and ballot counting processes, they are the areas that really need improvement. And I can say that over the past 20 years, there has not been much change with the processes. Of course, we did see certain changes in the past two elections, and that things have gone a bit smoother. However, for the deployment of manpower and the arrangements, I can see that there is redundant staff. So
in future how we can provide more training and enhance the efficiency of staff members is something we have to look into. I believe staff members should also be flexible, and I think more training has to be on that aspect. Now, the district council elections are going to be held soon, and I believe members of the public have high expectations and they want to see changes. So can the secretary talk about, say, in future, will the polling hours be shortened, for example? Because including the process for ballot counting, it will often go into the small hours, and people want to know about the results and they have to stay up late to see that. Can you perhaps announce the results before midnight? So that it can facilitate voters and members of public and candidates so that they'll know the results as soon as possible. Secretary, please. Well, thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Yu Patlan, for your questions. I did observe that Mr. Yu is very concerned about the ballot counting process, and I believe members of public are very concerned as well, because the polling hours are already quite long, and of course people would want to know about the results as soon as possible after the polling hours. So in the past two elections, we have definitely tried to improve the ballot counting process. And in the recent elections, we have seen that the announcement of results was much faster than elections in the past. In fact, in the last electoral by-election, I was late to the announcement of results because I did not expect it to be completed that early on. So, as you may have observed in the past two or three elections, we have definitely enhanced the efficiency. But of course, I think we need a comprehensive review and rationalization. As Mr. Yu Patlang said, we also wish to be more flexible, and we want to have better control over the process. With the comprehensive review and introduction of technologies, I believe the process can be shortened even further. That's what we want to achieve. Because on polling day, I believe everyone is exhausted. And if we can have the results announced as soon as possible, that would be ideal, and that is something that we're working on. Please do not worry. Now, in relation to the hours of the DC elections, we'll definitely take note of suggestions from various stakeholders, and we will set the period, and we'll definitely hear from various stakeholders in future. Chair, sorry, there is something that I wish to speak. Well, you're past the time limit. You can probably speak in the next round. Next, Mr. Tan Fei. Well, I do understand why the two posts have to be created, because with the changes made to elections, of course, we'll need new posts to deal with such changes. Now, on 23rd of March 2022 and 28th of April 2022, there have been two data breach incidents in relation to improper issuance of emails. that are acts not in accordance with the guidelines by the staff members. Now, I believe the two posts will or should deal with that. Will there be specific functions on dealing with potential data breaches? Because I do not see much detail in the paper on that. Now, as I taught before, I'm quite sensitive to the wording in paragraph 4A. It says that providing more polling stations and substantially increasing the number of ballot paper issuing desks. I believe there is some confusion in the Chinese version that may cause public misunderstanding. Can you clear that up, please? Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Tang Fei, for your comments and questions. Well, in relation to the ballot paper issuing desks, of course, in a Chinese version, it sounds like invoice, and that may cause some confusion, and we do take note of this, and we'll look into it. In relation monitoring the conduct of staff members, for the two staff members concerned, the two supernumerary directorate officers, they will definitely look into, apart from enhancing the efficiency of the processes, they will look into the strengthening of security of the processes. That is one of the areas that they will look into. Now, in relation to the procedures, if there are potential security threats, they will look into it, propose solutions to make sure the whole process is secure in terms of information security. They are not specifically going to monitor the performance of the staff members. They will look into the workflow and the practical arrangements. Well, if necessary, if they need extra steps to monitor the performance, they can look into that in future. However, it would mostly be other supervisory colleagues that will be monitoring the performance of staff members. Next, Mr. Robert Lee, please. Well, I do support the proposal, and as other members have said, in relation to the introduction of technologies to enhance the procedures, I have some questions and comments to make. I do agree that more technologies should be introduced to streamline the process and to minimize the errors. With the submission of forms or with candidates making payments, I believe electronic methods can be used. And I think, and I hope the Bureau can make use of such technologies in future. In relation to voting, I believe many countries and regions have different arrangements. So whether it's internet or electronic voting, for some countries, they have rolled that out. However, they have rolled them back because they had trouble with the verification of identities or security or reliability. And that they believe further research was needed. So I want to ask if the Bureau has any consideration on the fact that you have to strike a balance between efficiency and security, because much information, if there is a breach, can be leaked online, then that is definitely a concern. Now, in relation to the creation of the two posts, in relation to the technological functions, was the work handled by existing colleagues at the moment, or was the work outsourced? Thank you.
Secretary. Thank you, Mr. Lee, for your questions. And how we can strike a balance in the introduction of technology. As I said, the paramount consideration is the openness and fairness of our elections and to ensure the integrity and security of elections. If these principles are upheld, we will keep enhancing the arrangement and enhancing the efficiency and user-friendliness. We are now increasing the security and reliability of our arrangements. When it comes to means for voting, the colleague to be responsible for IT-related matters will consider the appropriate technology and look at the types of measures to be used. Yes, voting is a serious matter and has profound implications, and the process is important. If there are national security risks and systemic risks, then if a certain means involved for those risks, then they are not the most appropriate way to use. And without jeopardizing security, we can always apply technology. Can you tell us how the IT post can address these issues? Thank you, Mr. Lee, for your question. The new system Chief Systems Manager will have a whole IT team to support him. And together, they will take forward relevant IT projects. Any follow-up? None from me. Thank you. Mr. Dennis Lowe. Thank you, Chair. FTU also supports the proposals. The administration has already addressed our wish that we should not have permanent posts. As time changes, we want the administration to adopt technology in polling to address malpractices and unfairness. In past elections, civil servants were recruited to help handle the work. Civil servants were allowed to vote or to work in polling stations near their home so that they could vote as well. But in the last election, there was no such arrangement. Many civil servants claimed that they had to travel for a few hours or a long way in order to vote. I hope you can make better arrangements so that in the future, even civil servants helping with elections can vote. Election involves expenses. The longer the polling hours, the higher the expenses. I hope you can reduce costs by shortening the polling hours. Government finances are tight. You want to reduce expenditure. I hope you can address our aspirations in this regard. In 2015, some members from the opposition camp, when checking the voter register, applied for disqualification of their voter registration. when they saw voters not from their same camp. So when voters receive notification that they're going to be disqualified, they have to spend time to appear in court, and this is not fair. I'd like to know whether any complainant will have to provide evidence. Do they have any legal consequence for making such complaints? Because some innocent voters may have to appear in court. And then in 2015, the labor sector had 3 seats, and it took the longest time for this constituency to announce their results, because electronic counting could not be done. So I'd like to know whether that can be done better in the future. You really have to streamline your procedures, because in the last round of election, some polling staff put ballot papers into drawers, and they could only be identified after a long search. So I hope you can streamline your procedures, and if there is any electronic way to deal with documents, please do explore. Secretary, regarding the polling hours, I commented on that a number of times already. I do understand, and a cost is one consideration, and we will take this into account in our review. As regards arrangements from the LEO, I defer to the LEO. Thank you, Mr. Lung, for your question. Yes, for a vote counting, we will consider various ways and means to shorten the time required. And you talked about objection to voter registration. Under the current mechanism, there must be due evidence before the office will consider. And we have tried our best to do away with form-filling requirements. We use IT to assist as far as possible. For instance, we use barcode to follow up on the documents. Yes, this will form part of our review. We are going to review the polling procedures, and what Mr. Leung said will form part of our review. Our intention is to further streamline the procedures and arrangements. What about civil servants taking part or helping with polling? Can they be deployed to polling stations closer to the home? In deploying civil servants to work in different polling stations, they don't really have any choice. We deploy them to different polling stations, but we will assign them to a polling station nearest to their home. But sometimes there is a mismatch. We try our best, but there may not be polling stations close to their homes. In that way, we have no choice but to deploy them to polling stations further away from home. But we'll do so as far as possible. Dr. Charmaine Kwong, thank you. If we can, before the next election cycle, let people see the full effect of the improved electoral system, I support the creation of polls. Sometimes it is not about technology. For instance, for the EC election, the electorate size was 1,500. You use optic devices, And we use the same in our university, but I understand that you have to confirm whether everything is order, whether you have complied with all statutory requirements. But then the polling ended at 10:30, and we had to wait until 4 or 3 p.m. before we could see the results. And you're going to streamline the declaration procedures for election expenses. Currently, it is really too complicated. For instance, all candidates may fall into your trap because currently the requirements are very cumbersome. You have to move ahead with the times. Nowadays, publicity is usually paperless, and you said that you may want to consider introducing electronic voting. I'd like to know, when can we see the use of electronic voting? We're not asking for that for the coming DC election, but can that be done in the next LC election? We have talked about this for many years, and we have seen secretaries for come and go. And can there be an external consultancy commissioned? Because you are insiders, you may think that the procedures are all right and they should be the right way to do it. But then can you ask international consultants to see whether there is room for further improving the situation? Take US presidential elections and preliminaries. We can see AI. Now, that will be against the law in Hong Kong. Those will be regarded as in a false declaration. So please do not just consider whether you have ensured that the system or the procedures are fair, but you might not have advanced with the times. Secretary, thank you for your suggestion. Referring to the last EC election, indeed, the EAC report set out the details of the election and also mentioned the inadequacies of the election. Yes, it was not desirable given that the number of voters involved was just 1,000 or so. So EAC has put forward recommendations to improve the situation. So you should not just look at that EC election. You should look at the arrangements for the general elections of the LC, by elections, etc. And then you can see efforts put in to improve the situation afterwards. To be fair, for the elections that followed the EC election, in terms of voters' experience, the time taken to announce the results, etc., there were much improvement. There was much improvement compared with the EC election. So let's be pragmatic. We want members to understand that we are working very hard to do it well. We want a comprehensive review of all the arrangements. We are very committed. As for electronic voting, if that can be done and if it is acceptable to the public, indeed, it can greatly enhance our efficiency. We can be more efficient in ballot counting and even in streamlining manpower. But we have to look at whether the technology is mature so that it can be used appropriately. We also have to consider whether the public accept such an arrangement. Can we have electronic voting in the coming LC elections? I dare not give you any undertaking. Of course, we will carry out all sorts of studies and considerations. Of course, that will form a part of our study. Now, but if you say that we have more than 2 years to go before the next election, for sure we should have electronic voting. I dare not give any undertaking here. Assuming that it is feasible and it will not affect the openness, fairness, and integrity of elections, of course, without jeopardizing efficiency, we will move towards this direction. As for arrangements to keep up with the times, yes, so this is our direction. We will see how we can use appropriate means, including the application of technology to improve our efficiency. Yes, that will be our future direction.
Now, there are three other members who wish to speak for the first round. Mr. Li Chen Kang, Judy Chan, and Mr. Ma Feng Kwok. If there are no members who wish to speak, we will draw the line because we have discussed the item for over an hour. Then I'll draw the line if there are no other members who wish to speak. Well, Mr. Li Chen Kang, please. Thank you, Chair. I myself was in the 2019-2021 Legislative Council election and 2021 Election Committee elections. So I can see the efforts of the Bureau trying to improve the processes in various areas. So I do appreciate that because I believe members of public can see the results as well. However, I do see there is room for further improvement in the processes, and I believe the Secretary would agree with me. As other members said, we do support the creation of the two posts because they address the areas of concern in relation to the problems relating to voters and candidates. I believe technology is definitely going to help and it will minimize costs. It will minimize costs in the sense that it will reduce the number of staff members required as well as other costs. So what kind of costs will be minimized exactly? In relation to the declaration, will you set up an app, say on WeChat, to facilitate candidates' declaration so that they do not have to use a computer to make declarations? My third point is for voters, 2 or 3 days before polling day, they would then decide whether they want to vote. And then they would realize they were in fact not voters. With our technologies being so advanced, could you provide an opportunity for voters to register, say, 24 hours before the polling day so that they can vote on polling day? Well, Secretary, please. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Li Chen Kang, for making some very practical suggestions. Well, you asked about how much can be saved in terms of costs. Well, I have to be honest because we have yet to conduct a review. We cannot say for sure how much we can save. On one hand, we have to ensure
that the elections are held in a fair and honest manner. The integrity should not be affected. We also have to enhance the user experience and streamline the process, on the other hand. If we can improve these various aspects, it may not be a financial cost that is saved. However, if we can minimize the time required for voters, then of course there's the time cost involved, and that is an enhancement, and it is a reduction in costs for society in general. With the introduction of, say, new systems, if we have to ask the council for funding, we'll definitely outline the cost effectiveness aspects of the proposals. During our review, we'll definitely update the council on our progress, say what kind of measures we want to implement and what we hope to achieve. So, Mr. Lee, don't worry. In future, when we have started our review at different stages, we'll definitely report to LegCo members on the progress. In relation to the use of applications, as you may have observed, this is very commonly used these days. With the creation of the two posts, especially with the chief systems manager, they will look into the feasibility of adopting such technologies to streamline and enhance the procedures. That's why we need the two posts. One is with the specific streamlining of the process, and the other would look into what kind of technology can be used to streamline and enhance the processes. So I do thank you for your suggestion. We'll definitely try to adopt more applications that are commonly used by members of the public to facilitate the experience. Now, in relation to whether people can register 24 hours before polling day to vote, well, I'll let the REO answer that. Thank you, Chair. In relation to what was said about registration 24 hours or right before polling day, however, as said in the legislation, there is a deadline for voters to indicate their registration and eligibility, and we have to, in accordance with legislation, issue poll registers so that members of public may have to raise objections in relation to the disqualification of voters, and such decisions would have to be considered by magistrates. And in the end, we'll issue a final register once the process is completed. So under the current legislative framework, we cannot really do what was suggested by Mr. Lee, in the sense that we will allow registration 24 hours before polling. Next, Mr. Judy Chen, please. Well, as similar to Mr. Lee, I have experienced the past elections, and I have observed improvement in the elections, and I could see that the secretary was at the venue the whole time on polling days. So I can see that the secretary is quite dedicated. And the secretary gave a humble answer in relation to a question raised by another member in relation to electronic voting. I do want to highlight that because the post is time limited, it is only going to last for 5 years, how can the secretary or the bureau make sure that these results can be delivered in time? I also want to see that for voters, it can be fully electronic as well in relation to the issuance of polling registers, for example. Maybe it can be issued via I Am Smart. I saw on I Am Smart for various departments, applications can be submitted through the application. However, photo registration cannot be performed via I Am Smart at the moment. Can you perhaps introduce that function on I Am Smart as soon as possible? Perhaps you can just put a hyperlink in the application and that would do. Thank you, Chair. Well, Secretary, please. Well, thank you, Chair. Thank you, Ms. Judy Chan, for your comments. In relation to electronic voting, as I said, we're being quite pragmatic. In the past elections, well, actually, when I was working in the Immigration Department, we have adopted many automated technologies. Now, if we are talking about voting, we can perhaps adopt biometric authentication technologies to ensure the voter is indeed that voter, and then the ballot can be counted. Well, I thought that was quite easy, and that was my consideration then. But you have to make sure members of the public are accepting of this arrangement, that they trust the system enough to accept such arrangements. That is something that we have to consider as well. The technologies are definitely there, but we have to make sure members of the public accept that technology. And if that is what they are inclined to do and they trust that, they are protected. Well, in future, during the review, apart from looking at which technologies to use, we'll definitely consider the views of members of the public. That's why I said we have to be pragmatic. It's not just technological concerns. As Dr. Chaman Kwong said, because it doesn't really take that long to implement the measures because the technologies are quite advanced, we have to consider various aspects. Because there are several million voters in Hong Kong, we have to consider their views for them to vote for people they want. We hope that people are satisfied and they accept the arrangements. Well, I Am Smart. Well, actually, I want to talk about what the Secretary said about acceptance. I think you can just provide options so people can go either with the paper option or the electronic option. Now, as for the I Am Smart issue, REO, please. Well, the REO has been actively looking into using digital signing functions and other functions for voter registration. So for this year, at certain registration of persons offices and universities mobile stations, we have tested out such measure in that we will use I Am Smart for photo registration. We have received 400 odd applications. We will definitely look into enhancing the I Am Smart application. We hope that in the photo registration exercise next year, we'll fully implement the I Am Smart voting registration measure. Thank you.
Mr. Ma Fung Kwa, thank you, Chair, for allowing me to speak, although I'm not a member of the subcommittee. para 6 said that the many measures to improve our electoral arrangements have been distorted by people of ulterior motive. This is a fact. I've taken part in a number of elections. Now we have over 2 million voters, and manual ballot counting is time-consuming. Other than that, other arrangements are rather smooth. And LC elections are once every 4 years, and EC and C elections once every 5 years. People are saying that in between the elections, the workload of the RUO is relatively easy. They're there to update our voter registration and promote voter registration. You have already got, you are going to have 2 additional directorate grade officers. I'd like to know the division of labor. Why you need a term of 5 years? After you have gone electronic, of course, you may not be able to do that in the coming DC elections, but theoretically speaking, we have more than 2 years to go before the next LC elections. Once you have gone electronic, you can save a lot of resources and manpower. So do the 2 posts require a term of 5 years? Even after introducing electronic voting, you have to review the outcome. That would only take a few months. And how much resources and manpower can be saved after you've introduced electronic voting? I think that question has been asked. How much can you save, and when can we expect a report? P.S. Thank you. We've been explaining that we have to conduct a systematic review of our electoral arrangements, and many elements are involved, from voter registration to nomination of candidates, and also nomination of the electioneering teams. Well, this is nothing new. We've always had those arrangements, but we have to review the procedures and the adoption of IT. That is not that simple. You ask what the 2 posts are going to do. One is to review the overall procedures, and second, to support with information technology. So the 2 posts are interrelated. As we proceed, we will keep the council updated. If we require funding support for large-scale IT infrastructure, we will seek funding from the council. Assuming that the paper is passed today, you will get the support of the Finance Committee. The question is, after the next LC elections, and after you have conducted a review, which will take a few months, then the work is already done. Then I believe you can trim the overall establishment of the office. How are you going to redeploy resources and manpower? Won't you be able to make savings? P.S. As mentioned in the paper, for some systems, upgrade, and to support the change of procedures, we may have to straddle more than 1 election cycle. Yes, we will proceed quickly, but with the support of the 2 posts, we are going to have overall steer and leadership for the work. Mr. Ma Fong Kwok. Yes, the procedures are always there, and it's exactly because the procedures have been in place for so many years that there is room for us to improve and upgrade. And that is exactly why we need the 2 posts. Now, even if we don't review the procedures, they will run automatically. But it's because we're not happy with the current procedures. We see room for improvement. We need a comprehensive review. A lot of things are involved. Voter registration, voter register update, and nominations, election expenses, electioneering, employment of staff, equipment, storage, and logistics, and transport of ballot papers. Different aspects of elections should be reviewed. We haven't done a full review after so many years of operation, and we would like to have an overall review of all these steps to see what can be improved. Members have told us, through your own experience, that some arrangements are already obsolete, and then we want to improve all those things. This is what our work involves. This is rather a mammoth exercise. And if you ask me, we need to continuously improve our arrangements so that we can catch up with the times and we can have reforms. This is an ongoing process. In the coming few years, we're going to work very hard. In particular, we hope to achieve easily observable results in the coming LC election to convince members of the public that this is something that needs to be done on a continuous basis so that Hong Kong can remain a smart city. And even in our electoral arrangements, we will not lose out to other jurisdictions. So we're only asking for two time-limited posts. And for what resources in the office will help us to do what we plan to do. We are not spending a lot on these steps. We're only asking for two additional posts. Mr. Lai Tong Kwok, second round, 4 minutes. Thank you. I'd like to follow up on my previous question, and that is when the administration plans to confirm whether biometric technology can be used for verification or authentication. So, my question for the Secretary is, when can you complete a preliminary review of your work? And then can you tell us, or can you undertake to give an account of your review to the CA panel in a timely manner? Secretary. Thank you. Our preliminary thinking is, assuming that we have the support of the subcommittee and the two posts are created, then we will review each and every step of the election process. We will have different areas covering voter registration and nomination of candidates, advertisement expenses. We will divide the review into different areas, and we will review them one by one. There will be the division of labor. Under the two new posts, so we will have different committees, and then they will review the areas assigned to them on a regular basis. And if they identify room for further improvement with practical suggestions, then together with the IT colleague, they will see what kind of IT support is needed. The colleague overseeing the review will monitor the work of various task forces as regards new technology that can be deployed at different stages. Of course, biometric technology is one, but there are other new technologies as well. The kind of technology to deploy will depend on the outcome of the review and also their considerations. Whether we will get back to the council, yes, we will come back to the council in due course to update you on our progress. All right, my second question. As a definition of ordinarily resident in Hong Kong, many people are now working and living in the Greater Bay Area. They want to register as voters, and then they are somehow affected by the your requirements. Under Article 26 of the Basic Law, residents of Hong Kong have the right to vote and take part in elections. Permanent residents of the Hong Kong SAR shall have the right to vote and the right for to stand for election in accordance with the law. Very often, the judgment of the court will base on circumstances of the case. So it's easy. You just amend your legislation related, electoral legislation. You change the definition of being ordinarily resident in Hong Kong, and that will settle the matter. Please consider this. Thank you. We fully understand your view, Mr. Lai. Of course, if society sees the need and if we consider it necessary, we can consider amending the legislation. Last member in the second round, Mr. Yu Pak Leung. Thank you, Secretary, for your very sincere replies this morning and your determination to improve future electoral arrangements. Now, we all want future electoral arrangements to be further electronic, to go further electronic, and then there can be digitalization to facilitate more voters to come out to vote. Now, if we deploy food technology, we must remain paper-based voting for the benefit of our elders, because if we implement electronic polling, then it may pose difficulties for elders. As you know, I am in the tourism sector. The black code or the health code for visiting the mainland is a problem for the elderly. We all want the black code to be cancelled as soon as possible. Many elderly persons do not have smartphones and they have difficulties in crossing the border. While we want to facilitate voters, we have to ensure that our elderly persons can continue to exercise their voting rights. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Yu Pak Leung, for your very thorough consideration. It's true that when introducing new measures and policies, we have to consider all aspects. We want to be pragmatic and also be grounded. If we do not consider implementation details, we may not be able to satisfy the needs of different members of the public. In future, we will fully consider these aspects in order to be people-oriented. Any further questions? No? Then we have completed the questions on this paper. And I'll put this item to the vote. Will those in favor please raise their hands? I think we have unanimous support. Any objection? No? All right, the paper is endorsed. We have to vote on the next item. Do we recommend the Finance Committee to further discuss paper EC 2024-12 in accordance with Paragraph 2 of our ESC rules? We have to vote on whether we recommend a further discussion of paper EC 2023-24-12 In accordance with paragraph 40A of the procedures for ESC, I put this following item to the vote. This subcommittee recommends that the Finance Committee have a further discussion of the proposals passed by this subcommittee in paper EC 2023-2412. Now, if this is passed, that means we recommend the Finance Committee to further discuss this paper. If the motion is negative, that means we do not recommend the FC to further discuss this paper. Would those in favor please raise their hands? No. Those who oppose, please raise their hands. Unanimous objection. All right. So this motion is negatived. That means the ESC doesn't recommend the FC to further discuss paper number EC 2023-2412. All right, that completes our agenda. This is also the last meeting of the ESC in this year. May I wish you a relaxing and fruitful recess. Thank you, Chair. I want to thank members and the Chair for your support. We will do our utmost in the coming elections. We'll do our best in making the arrangements. Thank you very much, Secretary.